som player var vi Sten.
Skal vi huske, mobilerne skal ikke være alt for tæt på den der, vel? Var det ikke et eller andet med, at den interfererer eller sådan noget?
Ja, det kan jeg godt.
Gør det ved sidste år, tror jeg faktisk.
Sådan der. Options. Left to the right. And hvis jeg lige kan... Hallo? Ja, det er klart, men de er kun rullet to. Åh, for fint. Nå, jamen det er fint. Yes, tak. Yes, vi er inde i den, når vi er klar. Tak. Hej. Så vi skal lige have...
6142.
6-1 til
Babylon. Babylon 6-1, Sten 4-2.
Yeah, and we are live on the stream, and it's a little bit hectic.
Hello, Backgammon fans.
And I will change the X key here, just a short second. Oh, this is where I am actually in the room, so we have a few minutes now. So I will just change the X key, and yes, welcome.
Thank you.
Maybe present yourself.
Thank you very much. This is Jess Danielson, BMAP Grandmaster. I will try to comment today on this treat of a match between Alain Babylon from France, I'm not sure if I pronounce it 100% correctly, and Steen Grønbæk, I pronounce that correctly, from Denmark. A little player introduction, maybe. Steen Grønbæk is Danish champion, a well-rounded player in Denmark. He is feared and respected by everybody here. He has been the tournament director of Nordic Open for several years, and this year he is playing, and it's going well so far. He's a great player, that's all I can say. He's my teammate also. And do you have the moves, Fule?
No, I am kind of lost here.
You have to maybe change
it.
The direction.
Yeah,
that would be
I'm still a little behind,
but that's it's a 2-something.
I don't think I have this one. So yeah,
after double six, he fanned, and Steen hits with a deuce, I believe.
Two.
Okay, that's introduction for Steen. Alain from France. He's been on the circuit for many years. I must admit that I don't know anything about his game. It will be really interesting to see how he plays today. So, a great matchup, I think. Is this a... No, Steen has doubled for many rolls ago. You missed that?
Yeah,
okay,
missed
maybe? Okay, too bad. Thomas or Fule is trying to transcribe on the side here. And we have already missed some moves, unfortunately, but...
I'm up to speed with the position now, but I have missed the cubes.
Yeah.
I just need to place that sometime.
But Steen is blitzing away, and Alain is in now. We have to play the 4. Probably run away from the 20 point. Or if he goes 13-9, he duplicates a lot of 4s. But he runs away from a point that he does not want his opponent to make on top of his head, and I like that. 5 deuce, that's a bad roll for Steen. He cannot hit anything, he cannot anchor up, he can make his 8 point, but he will sacrifice a blot for that. What to do here? Maybe all the way from 20 to 13, escape a checker. He will be sure not to get pointed on if he moves the one on 20. I actually like that one, I think. There's no connectivity between Alain's two back checkers. So he will probably have some blots next roll if he rolls a 6. I think he should play 20 to 13. If he takes two down from 13, then he duplicates the deuces. But still, it's really bad to get pointed on up there. Okay, he has the way better board still, but yeah, he's really taking his time here, and I like that. Yeah, he finds a good move, I think. What does XG say about that?
I'm still in edit mode, so
okay.
Just one second. Okay,
we're not sure yet, but 5-1. See if he opts to hit here. He must hit, but he has two blots now. Entries with fours and fives hit in return. He doesn't do anything, so in on 20. Y slot there. Does he not want some daylight?
5-2 was correct.
5-2 was correct. That's
yeah.
Nice. I'm not totally lost. 2-1 I'm not sure about, but I would rather step up to the 22 point, but oh well. He can make the point now, the 5 point now, and what's the other dice?
It's a three,
yeah. Okay, that looks good. He has a 5 point board now, Steen, so Alain must be really careful. And he can make the deuce point, that looks good. What is that? 6-2s? Oh my.
Yeah.
What a fan. 6-5. Not a great roll. Maybe 2 down from 13, leaving 7 shots with the aces. He's contemplating making the ace, but that's really deep. That's not the point he wants right now. And playing to the deuce is also too scared, I think. But okay, 7 numbers. That's a lot. It's real expensive.
Could he come down with the 5?
Yeah, that's what I thought initially. I think that's the right play, because then he has a lot of flex in his position. But he does get hit 7 times.
Is it better than just to play 2 over, perhaps?
2 over is still an indirect 6.
Yeah.
So that's also a lot of shots. It's more shots than this, I think.
But where he will then also be solving his old problems.
Yeah,
I
true,
guess.
True. He still has that 16 point to clear. So, and he... Oh, to the deuce. That is not good. I
XG
don't
like
that.
It.
The XG likes
yeah,
it. I don't. Okay.
Oh,
yeah.
And the second best was 2 down from the 13 points. So.
And that's marginally...
yeah.
Okay, it's total... that was a toss-up between those two moves, but XG plays the safe one because of Steen's 5-point board. It is, you are done if you get hit, almost. You risk the gammon also, so yeah, it makes sense. But still, 2 down was really close. That's a killer, double threes, creates 2 points there. Oh my God, Steen better get in now. 4-5, wow, what a shot. Fantastic, he gets to fight another day. That was close, that the 4 cube would be flying, but he rolled a miracle. Steen gets a bad roll, he has to make the deuce. Point, maybe. I think you just make the deuce, yeah. It's not a good roll.
6-4.
The race looks fairly even. Can you?
Yeah. Alain is up 3 pips.
Okay, and then
before the roll.
Yeah, now he has a 10. He rolls 6-4, but he will. Maybe I don't know, because yeah, if he plays that all the way to the 6, then Steen has a double blot in his board, so that's the now. It's the time, if it's correct, I don't know.
Yeah, it is correct.
Yeah,
and
good.
Also,
good,
yeah,
well played, well played. Because of the double blot, it was an unfortunate 4-1 he got before. And now if Steen hits, he cannot cover, he can hit and lift the 6. It's a 4-5, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, must be right. Because Alain is up 4 pips in the race, and he has the cube, so you really have to take a chance here, don't you? He's just looking.
Yeah, he's up 13.
I think Steen will find the hit and lift from 6-1. Don't you think so, Thomas?
Yeah, definitely. And I've already entered in XG, and it agrees with lifting the 6 point and hitting.
Yeah, when you're behind in the pips and you have given away the cube, you have to take a chance. And if Babylon rolls the 3, so be it. He can also fan on 16 numbers, and that's really valuable. Yeah, well played. I like it. 6-1, he enters, unfortunately, for Steen. And he probably will play to 2. He should not come out onto the double shot. I don't think so. That one, it's not flexible. I don't like that. Steen.
Also gives him an error, yeah.
It was an error. It's 2 unflex. 4-1, yeah, safety. And then
first 6-5 with the 1, then.
Yeah, 6-5 is okay, yeah. It was either 6-5 or 3-2.
Yeah.
Okay, Steen plays this some flex. And Alain has a good position now. When he doesn't roll a 6, he can just stay back and wait for the double shot or something like that. Oh no, this is...
He's counting
the race. Yeah, the race dictates this move anyways, but still...
He'll be up 3 pips after the move, so...
But look at it, how many bad rolls Steen has
exactly.
If he stays
exactly.
back.
I totally agree.
It is driven, and he can play it without destroying his board. He strengthens his board, and it looks... Oh,
ouch.
Wow. That's a good roll. Wow. Fantastic, but still now Babylon is still happy that he stayed back because he can maybe get a shot. He cannot even run now, 2 down, and there are some shot numbers here. 6-1, 4-1. Wow, this is cover and hit maybe.
That's also the ultra safe.
Ultra safe is...
Steen is now up 16 pips, so
that one
actually talks for that one.
Yeah, because of the double sixes, yeah. So could be very right. He doesn't need to take the chance now. And the gammon is almost away anyways, so... There's only a few percent gammon here, I would say, if he goes for the hit. And but that he just loses almost a third of the games if he... if he opts to hit. What does XG say about this one? I would
say...
Well,
it's a close, and very close, and it's kind of funny, it's between the two, it's only 11 in difference on the top 3.
Oh, wow.
And the right one is the ultra safe, as he was looking at first. And then it'll be 7-3, 7-6.
Yeah,
so
only one blood.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And of course, 10-6, 4-3. So
yeah, because
XG wants to leave the blood on the 6 point. That's pretty much the...
I like it. Yeah, I like that. Because he rolled the double sixes. Oh, he cannot escape now with the 4-4, luckily for Steen. But because he rolled the double six before, then he has the race. He doesn't need to take that chance. 2. Just play him in. 2-4 and 2-2, I would say. Yeah, and 6-2. Better for the race, I think. Oh well, probably not the biggest. But now Steen is, he cannot do anything else but that. But if he had the chance to hit, he would probably have to, because after the 4 double 4s, the race was close again. Babylon can make the 4 point and lift the 6 point, and get shots on 6-1, 6-2, 6-3, 5-1, 5-2, 5-3. But there are also some pick and pass numbers, which he's not happy about.
He's
so
down 13 pips before.
Okay,
so
that's a lot.
Yeah.
But still, he destroys his board partly if he plays this one. But he opts to do it. What does XG say about that?
XG likes to run.
Okay, a run. And this is a shot number that I had not talked about, 6-4. Oh, and he hits and lifts. And no commentaries. Are we not live with the sound?
Yeah, maybe he's looking at the wrong stream. It could be.
Yeah. Okay, and Steen fans. And he gets a 4-cube immediately. This is a tough call. Yeah, he was on the wrong stream.
Okay,
you have
cool.
to for the commentaries, you have to go to the third Twitch stream.
That is correct.
Alrighty, this is a tough call. What's the raise here, Thomas?
Up 8. Yeah. White is up 8.
Yeah, entry for a 6 and then 2 from 4 to 2, then it equalizes. But I cannot see all the white's checkers. What's the last one? Oh, it is on the ace. Okay,
ace
yeah.
Point, yeah.
So it is 8 and generally, when you're down in the race here, you don't take that. I would say the chances are slim. If he fans one time, it's totally over. A mediocre roll, 4-3, whatever. He plays around, and Sting cannot take anymore if he fans one more time. What does XG say about this? I would
pass.
Yeah,
big pass.
Yeah, okay.
278. So
okay, big pass.
Yeah.
But Steen takes his time, and I like that. I'm sure he will find the right decision.
Yeah.
I would be very surprised if he takes this. Once he finds out that he's 8 pips behind, I think that's the key to the. To this position.
But Steen is pretty fast at counting, don't you think? So he probably already has that.
Yeah.
So maybe something else is going on. Is that the open on the 6 point that's kind of tricks him?
Probably. But and he's also looking at the possibilities of getting a shot.
Yeah.
If he rolls a low number combined with entry from Steen,
exactly.
but still it's not, it's too small of a chance. For the ones that are not used to count in what do you call it, mental shift or comparing positions, if you want a really fast way to count this position, you can just enter black with a 6 and then move from 4 to 2. Then you have 8 pips and then the two positions are totally equal. You do not have to count every single pip in this, and you can do that in many positions. I do it all the time. It works really well. What do you do, Thomas?
Oh, I actually count the checkers who are not equal.
Yeah.
So I would actually count the one on the 2 point and the 4 point and the 19 point and the 25 point.
Okay.
And then I'll subtract those two numbers.
Okay.
And all the rest of them I would not count.
Yeah. Okay.
Right here I would actually just do the count because it's pretty easy.
The whole
for
count?
Me.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
But you don't have to, but yeah.
No, I know,
yeah.
But it's if let's say he gets that he's up 8, it's
yeah.
pretty important if it's 50 or like 65 pips.
And he passes.
So, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, that's true. Yeah, it is. But generally, in those types of positions, you want to be at least ahead
yeah.
yourself
yeah.
before you can consider a take.
Yeah, yeah so maybe now I know this, but if Steen has been up 8 pips,
yeah.
it could have been a double and a take.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah.
I totally agree. But he took his time, and I respect that. That's good. Steen got quite unlucky in this game, I would say.
It went a little bit back and forth, I
guess. Yeah. yeah. But it was good for us, the viewers. We like the swings.
Yes.
Okay, standards here. What's this double 3? Probably make the 18, and then look at.
First.
A 5 point or a 3 point, yeah.
Probably
this doesn't
point, yeah.
sacrifice any point. If you make the 5, you give up your 8 point, and you like your 8 point in the beginning, so this is a nice move. And a double 6 is not good when Steen just made the 18, so this is forced. Well played.
yeah.
5-3, it's a miss. And what can Steen do about this? 2 to the 8 or to 6 and 5? Probably a little bit better.
Yeah.
6 and 5. But you do get a shot in a lot of sequences here. This one. But still, yeah, 2 to 8 wasn't that constructive. Okay,
maybe
here.
You should slot with the one.
Here the threes are duplicated, but still. Yeah. Two down.
That's probably good.
Yeah.
XG still wants the slot.
Okay, the slot. Yeah, to be more flexible and to begin a point in your own board. Okay, fair enough. Alan cannot escape his checker 6-2, so he has to slot to 6-4. But this gives Dane a chance to hit. How do we play a 2-5 here? That would be quite interesting. But or should you leave it there? I don't think so. It gives a great double four for Steen and some other indirects. Yeah, this looks good.
It's
but,
great,
but
it's only wrong by 10 to do the other one.
Okay,
so
Steen rolls a great double five. Now he counts. This is a bit more flex and 15, 17.
He's up. Yeah.
17. Yeah, I am almost there. 12 pips.
10 pips.
No, yeah, okay, that's a 7. Yeah, 17 and minus 7. Yeah,
yeah,
10 pips. Okay, thank you. That was the mental shift.
Yeah.
Almost.
In action.
Almost correct. Okay, but in general, for players that are not that used to playing, when you're up in the race, you race. When you're behind in the pip count, you stay back. So Steen moved the back checkers and looked and counted, and he saw that he was up 10, and then you just minimize the contact. So that's how it works.
It's 1-2, right?
It's a 1-2, yeah. There's
up 7 pips.
7 pips ahead. It's not enough, I would think. Or is it?
Yeah.
What is Steen's pip count?
97.
97.
104.
Okay.
So 7 pips up.
97. Oh, okay, okay, yeah, 97. And okay, 7 pips. So this is the minimum of race leads that you talk about. From 8 to 12%, your double window is when you have a race here. And this is almost, is this 8 pips or something? Or 8%? I would think so. So this must be a small double and a big take.
Very small double.
Yes.
By 22 and 282 takes.
Okay, this is a marginal double because he's below 10% ahead. And I think Babylon will acknowledge this. I don't know how old school he is. We will see. He has more crossovers, that might be in his consideration. He has 8 crossovers to Steen's 6 crossovers, but still, it's an easy take. But I guess he is counting. Oh my, okay.
Yeah,
that was.
But we don't know if he maybe has counted wrong.
Yeah.
So he
yeah.
got a different number.
That's true.
And that could also be a case.
But according to XG, it costs 282,
yeah.
and so that's
a big
mistake.
Huge mistake.
Yeah.
But.
In a race,
yeah.
where no gammons are to be thought about and so on, so that's a biggie. Okay, but I'm sure that Steen takes this knowledge with him to the next games. Because I'm sure that Steen knows that this is a take. So we might see him take some advantage of this later on.
Do you mean by doubling a little bit earlier
yeah.
in the race?
Yeah, now he knows that he's not fond, unless he counted incorrectly, of course.
Yeah, yeah,
that
Steen
is
doesn't know that, of
no,
course,
no, no,
either. So
no,
yeah,
that's always the bluff factor.
Yeah, we don't know what's going
no,
on
No,
there.
No. But I think that he will use this to his or try to use it to his advantage later. It's all about taking advantage of your opponent's mistakes. Here he can run or he can make his 4 point. If he's ahead in the race, he should run, I believe. He makes the 4.
Even race after the
even race,
yeah.
Okay. And Babylon has the much stronger board, so he wants to stay back where he's not being attacked. So it makes sense.
Now he should have run.
Yeah, double five. Now he's unhappy about that, but I don't know if he would have missed before. All right, 3-1 was this down, and safety, yeah. Have some respect for your opponent's strong four-point board.
Ooh.
Yeah, 3-6 would have hit a 2. Just the little small step up, and then, yeah, it looks good. And slotting a point you want to make in the future now, Babylon has to hit.
This is actually something I've noticed, that whenever XG wants to step up, it wants to step up on the earlier points,
yeah,
of the still escape and not in front of the prime as we sometimes are used to do.
Well, here it was being attacked by 3 checkers versus attacked by 2 checkers.
Yeah.
So it was much safer just to step up with the 2. And Steen rolls a big joker here. And it is almost over. Yeah, maybe he's too good. I would say he is too good here.
Yes.
What does XG think about that?
It is way too good.
Yeah, way too good. You have to try to squeeze some gammons out of this.
I was kind of respecting that he still had a far way to come around and down with the 2
yeah.
checkers and stuff, but of course he is on the bar. So.
Yeah. And what you can do is you can play on fairly without that much risk. And then if your opponent enters, you can cube out.
Yeah.
So here he stays out. That's perfect for Steen. He's still too good. Now he has a 2-3 that makes the board. He is afraid of the double fours, double threes.
And it's there where the mind games come in, because he's
good.
Afraid that he will actually end it with a fly shot,
yeah.
actually hitting that
yeah.
3, and then he'll
yeah.
get in trouble and stuff
but
like that.
But he's not in a huge trouble if he gets hit by a fly shot.
No,
he will
no,
get some
exactly.
returns. He still has the way better board.
Yeah.
Okay, and now he enters. It's interesting now. Will he cube out, or is he still too good? I think that the too good is away now.
I think he's still too good because he can hit on the 2.
He can hit. But his opponent still has a...
His opponent will take, you know, you also have to contend
yeah,
with
yeah,
that.
Yeah, yeah. And he
doubles
that. I like this. I really like
it. It is still too good. 133.
Oh, wow, wow. Okay.
So kind of
wow. But let's
see.
Yeah. Maybe Babylon thinks that he has a good holding game because he holds the 18 and the 13
yeah.
point against Steen's 13 point. So that is,
and it's a 767 error to
yeah.
actually take it. So
it's a huge
but this is,
pass.
This is a position I would also be totally blind in if I had something else on mind. I
yeah.
I could take something
yeah.
like that.
But the key here
the
is
board.
The amount of gammons that you go.
Exactly.
So once you acknowledge that, you will drop this
yeah.
in a heartbeat.
Or sometimes I find myself only looking at my strength as white in this position, the holding game,
yeah.
and you have timing, you have everything.
Yeah.
When you hit,
okay,
he
has discipline. Yeah.
So, but sometimes you just
yeah.
stare yourself totally blind on these kind of things,
yeah.
and then you end up taking.
Yeah, white only wins 22% in this position and goes 48% gammon, so it's a huge pass.
Yeah.
And Steen was actually still too good, but that was difficult. I think I would
yeah.
probably have doubled anyways also, and Steen made a blunder, so a fairly big one.
Kender du den der, hvor den ser procenten hernede på, om man, den der bluff procent?
Nej.
Så, okay.
Jeg bruger den ikke.
Nej, ja.
Okay.
Is it
so
6-2?
It looks like 6-2 to Alain. He started with an early double one, and Steen jumped. With the 3-6. You can split the backman and bring it, build it down to the 7 point. I think that's the right plan. Yeah, I like it. Well played, mister. Or monsieur. And here he can play to the 11 and 5.
You don't want to step up
yeah,
with that one?
No, because
no.
you enter
yeah.
the gun and you... expose yourself too much.
Yeah,
I think.
I think I also heard Breda once say that when your opponent is about to prime, you should also try to prime,
yeah.
and he's building down the builders then for that.
I like it, and I like his wisdom. KB,
Yeah.
That's a good roll. He primes his opponent. Okay, we should look at the comments in the Twitch stream, I'm told.
Oh, do we have access to that one?
If there are any, actually. But thanks to Carsten. What's going on here? 6-4 for Alain. He is looking at the deuce point. He does not want that deuce point, but it could be the best alternative of the worst ones. Because what can he do otherwise? Two down from the mid. Slot the three. Yeah, maybe. He really wants the his inner points in order. This is a deep point, but it still only leaves four shots, sorry. And what is Carsten saying? Yeah. Carsten says we should interact with the audience if there are any comments.
I am on the phone here and I cannot see any.
Okay, good.
See.
Great. Okay, he slots the 3 point. I do not know if that's right or not, but here he can hit and just shift a point from 8 to 7, probably. That was a good roll. What does XG say about the 6-3, 6-4?
Errors small. That's 20 error. It wants to make the 2 point.
But that's a hit.
This is it.
That was not a hit up there. Oh, okay, sorry. But it looked like it would be a hit. Okay, yeah, he shifted from 8 to 7. That's good. Now he can make the advanced anchor or enter and hit.
I think I made an error somewhere.
Okay,
that's
because
that
was a pointing move, right? Yeah. Okay. Okay, we missed some of the place.
See if I can correct that one.
He entered and hit, and he. I don't know if that was right. Not making the advanced anchor. He's really aggressive now. Steen has a choice here for a cube. He does opts not to. Oh, okay, that's okay. He has a 7 point, so that's fine. But Steen has the upper hand here. Alain has been real aggressive about attacking the last checker, and that's a theme. That you attack one checker and prime two, but I'm not sure if that's right when you could have made the advanced anchor, which was not being primed that hard, but I don't know. Has he played anything here?
No.
No?
It should be fairly easy.
Yeah, just clear the 22 point.
Yeah.
Step up and jump the prime. Oh, he makes the three.
Second best, but it's 120 euros. So.
Yeah, the 22 point move was better. Make a better anchor and try to escape a checker. Oh, this is the punishment right away. And he enters. No, no, sorry, he doesn't. Sorry. This must be a cube, huh? Yeah, I like that.
Just got to repair the position here, so yeah.
He passes immediately, so well played by Alain. But I wonder if Steen missed the cube, I don't know.
It did not look like that.
Okay, good. Alrighty. 3-2. This is still the beginning of the match. It's a long ways to go. Six, five, can you play it boldly there? Step out and down?
It likes just the running.
Okay,
but
the whole run.
It's not a big area,
okay,
like 10.
Okay.
So
because he had the better board and so on, but he's missing a checker on the 8 point. Oh well. He has a choice here to come in advanced on the 21 point and down with one looks good. And Steen has a 4-3, he can attack. I don't see an alternative. Maybe just to 6, but it's really passive. So, and he has the better board. I would play one down and attack. yep. probably.
XG likes that.
XG likes it.
And even 24, 21 and still attack, so.
Okay.
So it's pretty clear that you should attack with the
four. Yeah, yeah. Attack a single checker. That's the... oh, he hits from the bar. Nice roll. He can anchor up now, Steen, 21, and make the point. That's a fine roll, I will say. Alang has some cleanup to do. He can't do it without problems here. He should probably play super safe. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. This leaves sevens and eights. That's a whole lot of shots. Yeah, he looks at it now, the safer one. Because is he really forced to get that flex now? I don't like that.
It's just a 19 error to play this flex.
Okay, it was a small error, but still, you have to look over on your opponent's side and see what kind of board does he have. He has a 4-point board. That will kill you if you are hit most of the times. So, oh well, it was close because we also do like the flex.
Is he in the zone now? He's up 15 pips.
Okay. Okay, this is a take.
Yeah,
this is a take, I'm sure. Steen is still on the bar. I would double this, I think.
Does he need the 7 point first?
Oh,
it is a double take.
Yeah, yes.
57
and now he has probably lost his market.
Yeah.
I would think. And Steen doesn't even enter on the anchor. This is a pass now.
You cannot take that holding game on the 4 point?
No, not when you have...
24 pips down, that's of course a lot.
I don't take it when we have that straggler on the 24. Yeah, okay, that's
okay,
good.
Yeah,
what does XG
pass,
say?
Big pass.
Okay,
yeah.
Good. Generally, when you have that straggler, you go a lot more gammons, and it just loses so much more.
Yeah.
So that's a big liability. It would have been interesting if he had entered on this 20, 21.
Yeah.
I don't know if he had a take then. Probably not. I don't know. He had a good structure, Babylon. Alrighty. Another game. 3-3. Steen can double hit. Yeah, I like it. He has a stronger board. Or better. Better position. Of his, points. And then a board. He can hit, yeah, nice. It's a semi-blitz. Okay, blitz is over. Steen wants to make the ace point, probably. Yeah, when you have a blot down there, you generally want to make it. And then flex from 13 to 11, I like. Doesn't matter if you're four or two away from the opponent's stack there. That's good. It's a lot of flex. And he can hit, enter and hit, yeah. And he fans, that's not good, but still not a cube, I would say. He has some threats, now he can make a point. Don't fan again, Steen. He doesn't, he enters with double fives, that's awesome. And so six, probably. So we have the immediate threat if Alain should fan. Doesn't make any sense to jump out. Yeah, I like this. Now, if he fans on the 16 numbers, Steen has a lot of threats. And he does. Let's... No. Six. No, 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 Steen says. No, 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 monsieur. You cannot enter with the 6-5. And here comes the cube, and this is frightening. Oh, my God. Is this an easy take?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
130, so.
Good. I would have to count and look and sweat and... So on.
6-1 something?
Huh? 6-1, yeah. He hit with 6-1, yeah. Okay, but I might have found a take, but Alain was really fast about this. He must have a reference or something, or a stubborn afternoon, I don't know. But this is developing into a holding game, which he actually was thinking about, I guess. When he holds a point, he cannot get totally closed out. He did get the second checker hit, but Once he enters, he has a nice holding game and he has a nice board, which he can maybe develop further before he gets a shot. I don't know. Let's see. Steen looks at the deuce there, and what about the five? Probably just to the six.
Sometimes you should clear while the opponent is on the bar, but is it too much?
13-8, it duplicates the fours. It could be right. I don't know.
It could be what's that, 17 to 10?
Oh, so giving indirect fives and sixes. It could be. But Steen looks at the deuce right away. I don't know if
it's
this is too passive.
Yeah,
okay, good. It's correct?
Yeah.
Good, good, good. No shots. It's always nice. He fans again, and now he has a nice six there. Yeah, plays wonderful. Duplicating deuces, so that's really good. And he enters now and slots the five. And now we have this holding game. This is getting interesting. And Steen rolls a huge number. He can hit and create, make the seven. Probably just hit. Why leave it up there to all the other indirects? Yeah, he has to.
He's leaving shots anyways.
Yeah.
As well.
This is minimum shots and a lot of gammons if he fans. He doesn't. Oh my. And then one down. You probably have to. This can go either way now. Still a lot of gammons for Steen if he can. Oh my god, nope. Yeah, probably right just to wait. But now, it's not a nice position for Steen anymore. Out of harm's way there. What is that? Okay, 6-5 or something. He's not even considering a cube.
He's still down 50 in the race.
Yeah, but still. Look at the nice structure he has.
Yeah, he does, definitely.
But the threats, the direct threats are not really, really there. And okay, now he can split his 13 point, so he gets a lot of more ammunition.
Does he stay on the 8 point or go for the 7 point here?
Yeah, I would probably slot. Yeah, no. This is too passive. No. That is too passive. You have to split the men and probably, and slot the 7, I think. What does XG say?
It's
a blunder.
It was a blunder, yeah.
Yeah.
So
this is way too inflexible. He gives away two numbers, the deuce, the 2-6, but he could slot the 7 and give four numbers and have so much more flex.
So correct was 13-10 and 8-7, so it wants to slot the 5.
Yes, I like it. Split the 13 point and...
Steen has to come out here, right?
2-5. Yeah, he cannot bury a checker, he just jumps, yeah.
Take the chances.
Still one-third misses or something like that. Double deuces, yeah, it was 21 hits. But he hits now, and why not just make the point in the prime? It's a 4-3, right?
Yeah.
That's... What is he looking about? What is he looking at?
Has to be pretty standard.
Is he afraid of the... Oh my goodness, this is... No.
Right.
That's hopeless. Yeah, this and if Steen faints now, it's over. I would say. Oh, is he too good? No. It's
good.
Not too good when he has three men back. But this, I don't think Steen can take this. I would not. So there are. It's not all the force. Yeah, he just passes. It's not all the force that makes the prime. But still, if Steen faints another time, he's just totally wasted. What did...
Yeah, big pass, 150 euro to take it. So.
Big double, big pass. So, again, he was kind of unfortunate, I would say, Steen. But it's still a long ways. That's a long way to go. 3-2. Let's see if he... Yeah, that's good. That's theory. Well played by Alain. This is the 18 point and down to 8. No tempo hit and no too much safety. This is fine. Yeah, great. 3-2, that's wonderful for Alain. He gets his advanced anchor and makes a priming Yeah, he makes a priming point or whatever you say. So that
is
was
that 6-1?
It looks like a 6-1. He should probably just make the 5. Get the better board. No, this.
Well, it is 6-1 then.
It is 6-1.
Yeah.
But just. No. Just make the 5. Yeah, this is how it was. And this. Then Steen is not happy on all the fours,
oh,
I would say. Is
he
it wrong?
He doesn't like it.
He doesn't like it? Wow,
no.
Okay.
I'm
now, yeah, this is great. 3-1. You don't hit here.
It was the 8-2-6-5 move, actually,
wow,
that he was looking at.
Okay.
Very nice that he saw that.
How big was the difference?
Yeah, not much. Just small error, but still a 20 error.
Oh, a 20 error. I can live with that.
Yeah.
It's fine.
But very well seen by...
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, he looked at it anyways. Steen made the nice 5-point, equalizing the board strength. And now Steen can run with the back checkers if he's ahead again.
Up 4 before. So
yeah, that's great. 12 up after the roll.
Already has that count.
Wonderful. Yeah, probably. I don't know if he does the running pip count. I'm not sure he does, but he pretty fast can recognize that he's ahead. So that was a good roll for him. And now flex into the 2. Yeah, that's good.
And now it could come into play what you mentioned earlier if it took notice of his pass in the beginning.
Yeah, but this is a holding game. This is not a...
pure race. Yeah,
we
course,
still have the contact.
Yeah.
So it's a whole another position. But yeah, still, it can happen. It's your can.
Let's see, Steen is up 11 pips now, 121, 132.
Yeah, but he still has 2 points to clear out there. It's difficult enough with 1 point, and he could probably take with 1 point up there and 11 pips down. So with 2 points to clear, we're far away, I think. And this spells trouble. He has to clear... Babylon has a winning prime over there, so he has to play safe, and now his position deteriorates, gets even more on flex, Steen. So Steen is looking for a good number, 6-5, 6-1, something like that. 6-1, yeah. Wonderful. Great number.
Safe was correct, but you should have played it flexible. So to the 3-1 point instead.
Oh yeah, Babylon?
No, Steen.
Okay, yeah, okay. He could have flexed a little bit more. Yeah, okay. Now he has a double decision. What is this? How many pips?
This is exactly by 0.001. This is you're into double land.
Total borderline.
On the spot.
And this one he takes. That's
yeah,
good. Well played. Yeah, it's a huge take. 325. And Steen closes the game with one roll, double six. And the crowd goes wild in there, I can hear. Okay. So that's that. Now he's a huge, huge favorite now. What does XG say about the favorite here? Yeah, 86% or something like that. So he's a big favorite.
Just makes that doubling seem even better when you just roll a double six out.
Yeah,
right,
it's
after, right?
Perfect. And now double five. Yeah, he's cruising.
So is it gammon? Far from.
Far from. No gammons here, but...
two more, then we're there.
Yeah. There are some freak gammons here, yeah, but it's not real...
far away.
Yeah. Okay, and he's already saving it.
Yeah.
3 crossovers.
You heard us.
One. Yeah, exactly.
He got scared.
Not the most flexible position, Steen. If he rolls 4s, 5s, and 6s combined, he leaves a shot next time. Let's see. No, it's an ace. Good. He avoids it. This roll. Now he runs, and Steen leaves a shot on 6-2. 2-1 takes 2 off. Wonderful. 2 in. Yeah, I don't know if you should leave a 6, but oh well. A deuce makes it a bit more inflex. Unflex. And now he has to run. Okay, yeah.
He didn't save a six. Like to keep that six, spare that six, but not by a lot.
No,
that's
no, no.
Not even an
close.
Error,
yeah.
It's just because there's no gammons.
Yeah,
race,
exactly.
So.
And he cannot win the race.
Yeah.
So why not try to get a shot?
Yeah.
Mm.
That's the game, I guess.
And that's that, probably. Unless something freakish happens. No, it doesn't. He resigns. Oh well, equalizing 5-5. Great for the viewers. It's a 12-point match, yeah. I like the match length here at Nordic.
Yeah.
It's real nice long matches you get for your buck. And you also get a fighter's bracket if you're unlucky.
Yeah.
Or play worse, whatever.
I think, and I'm not sure, but after the change from triple elimination to double elimination, that they actually had longer matches.
Yeah, that makes sense.
So, yeah.
Yeah, makes perfect sense.
And the fighter's bracket is also to 13 points.
Oh, that's nice also.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was fourth
game. Yeah, nice roll for Steen. He makes the advanced anchor 4-1 for Babylon. Should he go under the gun? He doesn't have a constructive ace then. Two from behind, maybe. Duplicating threes, but it's a risky move. You could also just play it safe, 13-8. Just wait. I don't think you should step up, huh? Oh, you could play to the 18, sorry. Okay, maybe to the 18. This. But you cannot leave the blood there, right? You don't step up to 22 or something. 18.
Okay.
How about that?
No, XG likes 13-8, yeah. But you cannot make something
okay.
Completely. It's within 30 for the top six moves.
Okay,
so.
Yeah. The passive move, yeah, this one I do like, but it costs 20, but it's not anything costly. But yeah, I like it because Steen is not keen to hit on aces, and he actually misses here, so yeah, try to fight a little bit for the advanced anchor that he does want so badly. So now any six, yeah, he does get it. Do you leave the shot then when Steen has such a nice board? Or do you hit? No, you don't, huh? No, you don't hit here. He could leave a two shot. Or he could play 3-2, which he can remake very soon. Mm. Yeah, I do
XG
like.
XG agrees. Yeah.
Yeah, it's good.
Very
good.
Good.
Because Steen has a nice board now. What is this? 3-2.
I think it's 5-2. 5-2 or 3-2. Yeah.
Yeah.
Looks like 5-2.
Babylon got his advanced anchor, and that's
three,
the his biggest concern in the position. Steen was really threatening him, so. I heard a sigh of relief when he made the six. What is this? 5-4. Okay. Yeah, and flex. Looks good. It's a classic holding game. Players are fighting for the double rolls. Oh, this is a bad roll. He has to lift his 8 point now because he cannot leave a shot here, right? No. He doesn't have a constructive deuce anyways. Then he can to 7-1, but that make, oh, I don't like that. Oh, really?
That's a blunder.
It's a blunder,
yeah,
even.
So you should just lift the
There are so many numbers that hit and cover at least one of the checkers, or one of the checkers, and
see,
then
yeah, I can see the idea that that of course he has the two bluffs, but still.
But Steen was just
like
no, Steen was too strong, I think. Even though he had the double blood, I think that's why he played it that way, because of the double blood. But it's still 2-1, 2-3, 2-4, 2-5, 2-6. All of them hit and covered one blood. So, yeah.
Is this the time for Steen to run?
No, it's Alan's move, so
then it's not.
Can't be. And now he has the respect for the board because he has a 5-point board now. So that's good. Yeah. And he has to play super safe. And Steen can play more freely now. He has a strong, strong board, and Alan has a deteriorated board. What is this, 4-2?
Yeah, 4-2. Well, Alan still has that spare check on the 13 point.
Yeah. This is tricky.
Yeah, I think he should probably go now.
Yeah, it looks good.
XG likes it.
Alrighty. 3-1. This gets awkward.
Is it 2-1 since he?
No, 3-1. Hit and no. Can he hit and make? He has to probably.
Yeah, I think he has to.
Otherwise, he stacks his checkers on 1 and 2.
But then, would you have the 4-point or 3-point here? What would you prefer?
Less shots. So 5-4.
Yeah.
So it's only 5-3. Or the 5-3 is duplicated.
Yeah. And it's actually a big, big, big difference.
Yeah.
200 difference. The two, and
okay.
You should make the 4-point.
Cool. You have to minimize, otherwise you give 4-1 and double fours extra.
Yeah, that's very good to see that. Well, I was kind of figuring that would be probably more or less a matter of taste, but
nope.
That's a very big error. So
yeah. See, 5-3 is duplicated, so it's only 11 numbers, and it's a nice play. It's a gutsy play. Steen is contemplating if he hits a checker now. He gets, or he loses his market, but
it's actually only an 8 error to double here. So
an 8, okay,
yeah.
It doesn't cost
so
anything.
That was
it's
why
total.
He thought about it.
Yeah, it's borderline, so it's fine that he doesn't do it. Now he has to play down
and
lift.
And the funny thing is that he could actually redouble. He could double. Alan
on
could
a fan.
Double here. Yes.
Okay, because he has the threats of hitting a checker or covering his own.
Yeah.
So that is big, yeah, I can see that. But it's also a frightening position to cube, right? But here he can lift. He has to lift 3-2, I would say. Or he could play 4-2 from 4, but I don't like that.
And then just bring the 3 down?
I would bring it down and lift.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nothing fancy-panty.
No.
Shifting the 6 or anything like that, no.
And the 5s are duplicated here also?
Yeah.
So it's nice. That's the right one, I think, isn't it?
Yes.
Okay.
Definitely.
Good. Oh, that's a 3. Too bad. Okay, it wouldn't be this best. 2-1 fans. And what about now? He has 7s and deuces. Oh, this
now,
is sad. Yeah.
Now it does not like to double.
It doesn't.
No.
Oh, because he couldn't.
Funny. Yeah, because
he couldn't cover. Okay.
He
wow.
Lifted that
wow.
Part, so he doesn't have that threat.
But he rolled one of his best numbers, not hitting, so...
Is it too good?
Yeah, I would just roll.
Double pass.
Okay, it's not too good, yeah. 47, error to wait.
Yeah.
Okay, good. But, again, Steen got unlucky. He had the far best board and couldn't enter, and Babylon made a 3-1. A gutsy one, but
yeah.
Correct one.
Yeah.
And, Steen has not had a lot of luck here, I think, but the score is almost even still. What does the luck say, actually?
Only 0.5 in favor of Alain.
Okay. Yeah.
So the 4-1 was 2 there and then 6.
But if I was Steen, I would feel like I had some luck in exchange or left for a later moment. One.
Okay.
And what do you do here? Do you...
Down.
Again, against a single checker.
You could bring in 3.
Yeah, but do you need to bring in 3?
That would make the 3-point, I guess.
The
sometimes,
3-point,
yeah.
Yeah,
sometimes
yeah.
XG likes that.
Again, you don't give up your 8-point. This is a move. It's possible, but it's only against a single checker. Do you need that much respect? I would keep the 8-point. This looks it's really flex. This is really flex. And
I can say second best and third best is actually even, and that one is third best.
Okay.
But it's, and then it's 50 up to the best.
I would make the 3 point.
Yeah, that's correct.
Okay, bring one down. Okay.
One down and the
yeah.
3 point.
Okay. Yeah, it's only against a single checker and not two split ones, because then you maybe you want to play more conservative if you have a split backman or something like that. Okay, he played at double five, good for his race. Steen has a lot of prime potential. Two down from the 13, I guess. Slotting five, no, two down, yeah, I like this, I think. It only leaves 6-4. Double five again. Oh wow!
Starting to get awkward.
Yeah, 40 pips in two checks, but still, it's not good for his structure now. Yeah, he has to play like that. Steen has a lot of good moves, good rolls, I mean. And here, do we make the seven or do we make the nine? The seven kind of blocks Alang, but it leaves a 7 shot. Yeah, I like this actually. He's only one roll from 6 prime. He still has that 6-4, 6-5, double 6 that escapes. That's not good. But this, 6 shots. But yeah, it's the prime he wants.
Maybe he can make the prime next roll.
Mm-hmm. Maybe if he doesn't escape. This is give and take. Oh, he's totally looking at something else. No, five must be right.
Yeah.
And then
just quickly looking at just taking the 7 point perhaps, but
nine, I like this.
Yeah. That's also correct by
Alrighty.
Far.
Alrighty. Cool. Well played, Steen. He doesn't escape. He can make his inner board. Yeah, good. But what about the cube now? He has a lot of threats, Steen. Alan must be way up in the race. Yeah, probably right to wait.
Yeah, 105 errors.
Okay,
double, so.
It's an error to double.
Yeah.
Or blunder.
Blunder.
Yeah, good. Good decision by Steen. He is way down in the race, so that is why this is not a cube. And how do you play 6-3? Do you make the 3 point? Yeah. Leaving 8s and 10s. This is 6 numbers.
Any real good alternatives?
No, exactly. Then you have to stack on the 5. Yeah,
yeah.
This and this. This is super safe.
He is behind 27, and that's a big blunder here. That's a double whopper.
Oh.
So.
Okay, too bad.
Yeah.
How much did it cost?
150, I think.
Okay,
was,
169.
Yeah, 69.
Yeah. Because you have to take a chance, I think. It's too inflexible. And 6-5, he has the same problems now. He has to make the 4 point and leave.
Yeah.
Yeah, now it's only 4 shots. But
still, there are no alternatives.
No alternatives,
point.
No, there aren't. But he was kind of punished for his... Oh, he hits 6-3. Steen was punished for his inflex move, I would say.
Yeah.
One, make the 3 and slot the 7. Yeah, this is interesting. How about this? This is a nice holding game. Babylon only has 2 checkers pointing at Steen's blood, so he doesn't have a whole lot of threats. Can he cube here? What's the race must be...
36 up.
Okay, 36 up. He must double this then.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's just a double. It's
okay. Small double, big take.
Small double, big take, yeah.
Alrighty. Because Steen also has a great holding game. He does lose some gammons when he splits, but he also wins. If Babylon has to hit in some variation, then if he enters and hits re-hits, then he wins a good amount of games. Oh wow, this, okay, I would have cubed this. Does he count the race here? And how does he play this?
But he's still maybe afraid of those two guys on the 11 point bearing in against the 20 point.
Yeah, now he,
anchor.
Okay, could he, can he play it like this? Okay, yeah, good, super.
Yeah, yeah. So
yeah, I don't think I looked at the dice correctly or something.
Should he come up now, or do you just leave that check on the?
If he comes up, he has a nice holding game without any threats. If he stays back, he risks being blitzed. If there were three checkers, yeah, okay, I like it. But if there were three, it would be definite that he had to step up. But this is safe, and this is nice.
Yeah.
I do like it. Also, the double twos and the double ones and so on could shift. And now he cubes.
It was
correct.
A cube. Yeah, and still correct. Cube.
And a nice cube. He has a
still 36 up. So.
Yeah, 36 up. And I would say Sten can take this. He doesn't go any gammons significantly anyways.
After he stepped up, the gammons went from 9% to like 3%.
Yeah,
so.
That's really good for Sten. And now it's the other way around.
Yeah.
He rolls the massive joker. And Sten is totally wasted here.
Yeah.
Okay, that's how it goes. But they played well, both of them. And he even clears his 8 without any problems. Okay, Sten gets a little back, but he's still way behind. One, slot, and run. Yeah, okay, yeah, it's fine. Yeah, looks good. Very efficient way to play his checkers, Sten. His race equity is really low here, so he's just trying to stay back and get that. Why not take his checker off here?
Is he thinking about something?
Yeah.
Some hidden pass, maybe.
If he's hit and he don't want the blood and so on, but that's it's not relevant here, I think. Now Sten has to go on sixes.
5-2. Yeah.
And he cannot stay. He goes to the 12 point. Sorry. And he's just losing this one. Too bad. But it's all 1 or 2 point wins, these. We have not seen a gammon yet.
No.
So, oh well. Interesting. Alain will be up 8-5. Right.
Yeah.
Should we look a bit about on the PR?
Yeah, but you cannot really because I have had to fix a few positions, especially in the beginning where I did not get the cue.
That's true. Then let's not talk about that.
But let me just say that with those mistakes in the beginning where it was me who had not moved it correct, they have played down both of them. So
okay.
So they are playing top class.
Yeah. Good. And Sten got a 6-4 in the first roll, and he immediately made the deuce point because he's behind in the race, or in the match, sorry. So you want to try to play the move that gets most gammons, and that is how you do it.
Yeah.
So it's fine. You have to adjust to the match score all the time. He has a deuce here.
Do you just split those back guys?
Yeah, I think so. If you are attacked on the 5, you would like some flex and be able to make another anchor maybe. Go there, I don't know. It might be right.
Actually, likes it.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, by far.
Okay, good. It's not that dangerous than splitting. Leaves you vulnerable.
Especially to those double 5s.
Yeah,
so
yeah, that's true. He would be wasted.
Makes it look even better.
Yeah, makes sense.
just is the correct idea.
Mm-hmm. Well played. Oh, that's a fly shot. That's wonderful for Steen. Enter and re-hit. Probably has to. There's no other way to do it. You cannot play 9-6 here. He's really vulnerable with the blots on Steen's side, so he has to hit, yeah. This is also a tempo hit. And it gives him some chance of priming those back checkers. Steen has a lot of entries that hit. He's behind in the match, so he's contemplating. But are the threats enough? He has some real huge jokers, but oh well. 4-5 hits.
No double by 60, so.
Okay, yeah, good. Well played. Even though he's behind in the match, when you're behind, you have to adjust and be even more aggressive with your cube. Is this a 4-5?
No, 4-3.
Okay,
since he's
yeah. Good, yeah. That would be strange otherwise. Okay, an awkward. He can remake the 13 and play to 4. No, 3, sorry.
Yeah, what's the idea here? Because he has a lot of options and he has a lot of blood.
He can
afterwards.
Even cover the 9 point.
Yeah.
Duplicating sixes.
I like that one.
Yeah, and duplicating ones and sixes actually. Yeah, this must be the right idea.
It
primes. It primes, yeah.
So how about the 18 point? Is that, but where does it then play the 5?
Yeah, that's too many blots, I would say.
That's kind of funny, this one.
I didn't even look at the 18 point, but I think there's way too many blots. If he does make the 18. I like the priming move.
So this is probably finding the lesser evil.
Yeah.
So, and when you have a
this
position like this, just like how do you want to be when you get hit?
Yeah.
You want to have the prime? Do you want, you know, this is kind of reducing numbers and hoping not to get hit, but
yeah.
Is it then in his favor afterwards?
I would play the other one, I think, because...
Yeah,
kind
of like two.
Yeah.
But it's very interesting also because there are so many alternatives and this
yeah.
is really a game plan type of move.
Yeah, it is.
So we can see what his game plan will be and then we can ask XG afterwards, I guess.
I like this.
Yeah.
Duplicating sixes and ones.
Especially the duplication.
Yeah, there are some double hitting numbers, but not too many. He doesn't like it himself. He
it looks dangerous, but of course he has three bloods and you know, but still, yeah.
He opts to minimize the number of blots, but I liked the
yeah.
other one.
And it was by far the 9 point. So what do we
It
play
costs
here?
300
yeah.
to play this one. Wow. This was
That's
the
actually kind of wild.
The biggest mistake, and we see why here. Look at this. Wow.
And his team should actually double. So
okay, on the before the
yeah,
roll,
yeah.
and he actually rolled his best roll, actually.
Yeah.
So this was a huge mistake by the Frenchman.
And he fanned. And Steen is in with 6-2.
Yeah, Steen is playing too good now. Yeah. It was a difficult move, I would say.
Yeah, definitely.
Really
definitely.
Difficult. But it was the biggest mistake of the match so far. Made by the Frenchman.
Let's see the cube was actually kind of big, very big cube.
110?
110, yeah.
Wow, okay.
Steen
missed a huge no. He missed a huge double, actually. Because there were so many good combinations,
yeah.
probably.
Yeah.
Okay, Steen is playing too good, and he is blitzing away, and he is hit here. Still too good. You don't double this. Threes hit, deuces and fours hit on the other side.
70 error to double, and again, do we get the opponent to take here now all of
no,
a sudden?
No. I wouldn't say so.
No.
But yeah, sometimes you can find a good one from the bar.
Yeah.
And,
and as you say, it's kind of good that he, of course, stops up and thinks about it.
Yeah, it is. This is still way too good. He has so much blitz potential. But the 6 is awkward. Oh, wow.
Oh,
yeah. Ah, this is bad. This is really bad for Steen. Okay, and he enters and makes 1-5. He makes the point. Oh wow!
Oof, exciting.
This was cubes.
What about now?
And
now
he cubes. Oh, that's great.
And now it's a no double.
Okay. Wow. Wow. Okay.
So that's typical, but it's only an 8 error. So yeah. So that's really close, and
okay.
It's really good, nice.
It's a borderline,
yeah,
borderline decision,
borderline.
And Babylon might pass this,
yeah,
because he has been in a state,
yeah,
of. Okay,
no,
he takes. Okay, good.
Very good take.
Yeah, it's a good take. He has some structure now, and he has the ace point game to fall back on if it goes wrong. And I think it's a really good take.
Yeah. 450 euro to pass it.
Yeah,
so that's
a
really
huge
good
take. But
is that 4-2?
Yeah.
Since he's thinking again.
It does look like it, and he has
5-2
some.
5-2 would be easy,
an
right?
Awkward. Yeah, 5 would be automatic, but some awkward falls now. But
the thing is, does he lift or does he hit, right? That will also be with 5-2 if he should still hit or just run.
Yeah, 6-2 is probably mandatory, isn't it? 6-2, and then you look at the deuce, right?
Oh yeah.
Can you just?
Yeah, I'm thinking lifting the 7 point, but
okay,
that would be bad here. But
maybe. He
but just play 7-3, and then if it's a 4, and then hit with the 2.
It might be right, but isn't this?
Four,
I like this.
One,
yeah, this still primes the
exactly
ace point.
Keeps the prime.
Yeah.
Let's see. Yeah.
So
yeah, XG agrees.
Yeah. Okay, it's the right move. But another
he's
difficult
those
one.
Three, yeah, back checkers, of course, with
yeah,
the 7
primed
point. So.
Yeah, they are totally primed, but a difficult roll, and Alain has a 6-5. Flexes and gives some 9 and 11 shots,
yeah, like
which Steen really want to hit. What is that for one? That's bad. Steen's position is deteriorating. It's 4-1, right?
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah.
I guess.
Maybe. Yeah, it is. Oh, it's bad for Steen. He still has a 4-point board,
yeah,
to fall back on.
Okay. Yeah, Alain is leading the match, so he's not doubling right now.
Probably not, no. Oh, this would be crazy.
Yeah.
This makes the 7. Or creates another builder in the outfield, but I feel the 7 is the right one. He could play one out from 24, but still, those 7 and or 9 and 11 shots are expensive. Make the 7.
The 7 is the correct one.
Improve your structure, yeah.
60.
Okay, it's correct, but the other idea to create another spare in the outfield is also...
Yeah, especially when you have 3 guys back, right?
Mm. But it's really expensive to be hit, so...
Steen doesn't seem to like to run.
Nope. This is really bad for Steen.
That would be the 5-point up.
Yeah, you probably have to, but this...
How
is
about the cube then?
Really shitty position for Steen. He's
yeah.
There's
no
alternative, but he's
Still far away from a redouble.
Yeah.
Like 360.
Okay.
So that's not even.
Okay, this was a big number for Alain. Now he has 7s to cover.
Now it's maybe too good.
No, it's not too good. He rolls,
right.
Fantastic rolls.
It's a missed cube.
Yeah.
So,
could he take it?
Yeah, well, let's get back to that one. Oh, 1-6.
1-6.
It's alive.
And double fours.
Double four. It
doesn't
hit.
It covers. No, it can cover the the 8 point. But is that what he wants? Probably
yeah.
Not.
It was a redouble pass just before that
double
5. So.
Wow.
So maybe he has himself to blame.
Yeah.
That's of course.
The 7 immediate numbers, or the 6 numbers, sorry, that made the 6 prime
yeah.
Was just too threatening. Okay, this is 2. But can you split the backman there? You have 3, Steen has 3 builders, so some of his bad numbers becomes
very
good.
Yeah.
This is, oh yeah, I actually like
it's
this.
Gonna be good, yeah.
This looks good.
That's the right idea.
Oh, that's well played.
Like that one,
yeah,
yeah,
really well played. And Steen rolls well. Whoa,
ouch.
Fantastic. He's not out of the woods yet. But
he's getting closer.
Yeah. That was a huge number for Steen. 3-2 makes 5-2. No,
yeah, not yet.
Okay, it's only a 2. Nice. Yeah, he played the 4-4 really well, I think. Yeah. That was world class, I would say. He didn't want to split his backmen and be vulnerable.
Is that 6-5?
Yeah. Yeah, nice. 9 checkers left. Okay, double fours eliminates the gammon. 3 and 4. Yeah, it's okay. He's not threatening to go the gammon just yet. And here's the shot. He has to hit, I believe. So this will be the final shot if he misses. If Steen doesn't hit, then he can stay there for the next.
Probably also be the final if he just put it up, right? It's
no, then he can roll 3-4 and just lift some points in his board and so on.
Yeah, but it would still be a lot of rolls.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was definitely correct by the
way.
So
good.
No worries.
Good, good. And Babylon saves the gammon. And Steen gets closer in the match. Okay, exciting. He was so close to losing this one.
Yeah.
It was a double pass at one point when he threatened to make the 6 prime. So, wow. What do you know? Was that a big pass? If he had cubed?
Yeah, I think it was.
He still had 3 checkers?
Yeah, 120 or something like
okay,
that.
Okay.
I'll just check it in a minute.
Okay. Doesn't matter. Concentrate on this. when your opponent starts out by making a point, you should make a point yourself. So that's well played by the Frenchman here. Steen runs. And another 6-4. Not the one he was hoping for. But now, what is this? Is this right? Did he study?
Oh, it's out and down.
Yeah, I like that better. I don't know why he did this. Maybe you do it when the opponent has 2 checkers back or something, but not with a single checker. The third 6-4, he must be kind of tired of this role now.
Should probably stay.
Yeah, the small split, small split and down. I like this.
I'll probably aim for the 5-point. That's correct.
I like
good move.
Yeah.
Or
you would slot the
slot the 5
big split and slot the 5. Okay.
Yeah, or even just staying back with those 2 guys. But I can see it. Though.
Yeah. It's a good move. And 6-2.
Yeah.
He has to give a shot somehow.
Come for the 5-point here.
Yeah. It's not a hit. It's good. 4 and 6-4 probably.
Not the natural one on the 5-point. You want to keep that.
I like this
unstacking
the 6.
Yeah,
I like it.
XT actually likes to come up on the 20 points.
Okay.
21.
Okay. So you have your
6-4 is correct.
Yeah. So you have your checkers close.
Yeah.
And if you hit on one, you can.
Yeah. Come here, man.
All right. Yeah. Okay, Steen makes a point on his head, leaves 3 blots for both of them. This could be a hit, yeah, he probably has to.
Oh.
He fans.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
And then what?
Yeah. 3s.
Even match, 8-7 lead.
3s are duplicated, but
he's
just too vulnerable, I think.
It's a big double, right?
Yeah, cube.
Is it too good, maybe?
I don't think so.
Double
nope,
pass.
Double
very standard.
Pass. Yeah.
Oh,
he fanned at a wrong time.
Yeah.
And it just cost a point. That's how it goes. I think we will get another commentator.
Yeah.
Mr. Hans Christian Mathiesen will be here shortly. So I have someone to talk to other than Thomas, but
yeah,
well,
it would be nice to be
all
joined.
All right. Let's see when he joins us.
No, he's just finished a match. I'm not sure if he lost or won his fighter bracket match.
No, we'll find out when he comes.
Yeah.
We'll see if he smiles or
exactly.
He's sad. Okay, Steen rolls 6-6 and Babylon responds with a double 5. And here the race really dictates how we should play this.
So he is down by 2 pips after the move.
Who is?
Babillon.
Okay, then it...
But XG likes it. Okay. 5-3 for not? For Steen? I think it was something like that.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Probably.
Multitasking here. For it's not a skill for guys.
It's difficult. Okay, make and slot. Okay, slot all of them. Slot. Fine. I like it. The race is close. Do what's best for the race, or for the bear out, actually. Bear off. It's called.
Actually, Steen is up 15 here and 10 after the roll. So
okay, good. Good.
So he should he should not go for that 4 point. Yeah, he should. Not by much, but
Babillon?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
He should actually pay 8-3, so this is just a pure race.
Yeah. You want to do what's best for the bear off.
So Steen up by 10, 118, 128.
Okay, make the 5, and here he strengthens. It's fine. Double 3s. Leveling the race somehow. He's still behind, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, but I feel like, oh yeah. He, how about 13-10 with 2? It's easier to play his checkers later on, and he doesn't give up that much. I don't know what.
Yeah.
He played to the deuce, yeah. And Steen played 2 down.
6-5.
Yeah.
Didn't like too much that.
No, the 2 point was wrong. Because Babillon gets stuck with the 2 sets of checkers up there.
Or was Steen wrong? Can you remember that?
Sorry.
No. Getting lost. Yeah, 4-3.
Okay.
They move fast now.
Yeah, this is so fast. What was
that
it?
Was double 3.
Double 3, it must be. Yeah. And then Steen.
Something with 7.
Yeah. Oh my god. Okay, I have to concentrate now. 6-4. Looks good. Double 5s. Wow. This is a killer. 5 deuce, not enough.
Yeah, and he's down by 16, so it doesn't really matter how he plays it.
This is game over.
And if it's
here, you can also
illegal.
Just move the checkers that are not across from your opponents. So from 13 to 7, that's 6 pips. And then you move the stack on the 5, 4 pips. So that's 6 and 4, that's 10, and then from 6 to 1, that's 5, 15 pips, right? Was it?
16.
16,
yeah.
Okay,
pips.
I'm a bit off here. 6. Oh, yeah, okay, doesn't matter, but yeah. Do the mental shift, and you fairly fast find out how the pip is. And Alain found out that he was a lot behind. Okay, 8-9. 9 away, 8 away. Six, 4, nice shot. Making the 18 early. Yeah. Already. This is already a holding game of some sort. Four to the 4. Don't run here, right? You would have to be up in the race.
Was he down by 3?
Then you don't play this. And you just play to the 4. And he's probably counting. That's a good way to do it. And then he acknowledges he's down and then finds the right move, I think. He played down to 4.
Yeah.
Okay, 5 twos.
XG likes that.
Yeah.
There's a lot of 5 twos in this game. So now.
2 down, yeah, that's good. 2 big towers for Steen. Doesn't matter. This is a holding game. 4-3. Make the 4 and slot the 3. 3 and 4, yeah, okay, I'll do it otherwise, but probably insignificant, yeah, okay, good. He can run now, he's a lot ahead, but this is interesting because he doesn't have the points he wants, so even with a big race, I think Babylon can take fairly deep here. Yeah, he probably has to play to the 8, but a 30
that is just lead, so ugly, but it's correct and it's very well played.
Yeah.
I think I would just play to the 1 point if it was me. But
yeah, but you still want the checkers to be able to create something in the next rolls. So, yeah.
You should probably do the 2 point, right?
There must be quite some shot-giving numbers here, so Steen waits. What, is this double fours? No, 4-5?
I think it's 5-4, yeah.
Yeah, 5-4. And you have to play all the way there. Give an 8 shot.
Behind? No,
it strips too much.
It is 2 behind because he it's a blunder here.
Oh, it's a blunder?
Yeah.
Okay.
He cannot leave those shots. 110.
Okay. Okay. That was expensive, but I think Steen looked at Babylon's home board and
took
thought
the chance to clear.
This is now,
yeah,
because in the next roll now he strengthens his board, so would it be more fun to give the fly shot next time?
Exactly.
Okay, yeah, oh, that's a nice way of doing it, I think, probably.
Not a big deal, but it kind of prefers to make it in the right
order.
6-5, right?
Yeah.
Should be. So do you want to step up on the tower?
Do you want to leave the 8 shot, double 2, 4-4, 6-2?
So he already was in the idea of leaving that shot maybe as a builder, and but he sees it now and should go out.
Because it is a builder. It's both an asset and a liability.
Yeah, exactly. He cannot afford to get hit here.
It's 4 expensive numbers, but you gain some flex. And this is really inflexible. He has bad numbers here. En masse, as they say in France, I think.
Yeah.
So, but I don't know what the right idea here is.
It is the safe play,
yeah,
by far.
Okay.
And that's because he's, he has such a good structure over there.
Yeah.
I guess 170 euros.
So. Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That's big. For a misplayed five.
Yeah.
Okay. He's not keen on it. I can understand his thinking, but
yeah, me too.
It's just too expensive.
And you got that 5-3 also duplicate, right? So it's only 6-2, 4-4, 2-2. So
yeah, 4 numbers.
4 numbers, yeah.
Yeah, but still, it could be 4 numbers, 3 sequences from now.
Yeah.
It's not. He's not sure to clear it. Oh, this is a big blunder.
Yeah.
Actually, but a difficult.
He
hits. Whoa.
Right away.
Wow. Yeah.
Unless he
finds something crazy.
Yeah,
no,
he
doesn't. And he's too good now. Babylon, right away.
Yeah.
His structure is so weak that he becomes far too good right away. And we actually see the punishment from the mistakes all the time here.
Yeah.
It's not every game that happens.
That's been a theme.
Yeah, it has. Oh, wow. Second time he doesn't even enter. And now Babylon makes the board and he's way, way too good. Okay.
8-4. For that last guy.
I like that. 8-4. This is not
keeping the builders for
the
7 point.
Why?
He wants to trick those players.
Yeah. 3 builders for the 7 and a lot more hitters if he rolls the fantastic 1-6 and so on.
XT agrees.
Yeah. So. Exactly.
You cannot put a guy on the 7 point here. So what's the
secondary? Yeah, 2-4 and then out with the back checker maybe. He's looking at entries like 1-3 and so on. This this now becomes an easy 1-3. Before it would be a really bad one. Okay, that's too many, right? No, that's okay.
View, right?
Yeah, it's it's good. He plays 2-2 there, 1-1. I don't know, but I like.
Fans and
yeah. I like the 8-4, but
so now go to the 7 point, or
probably.
Yeah, there's nothing to be afraid of.
No, he has a blot to shoot at.
That's
good.
Right, yeah.
Well played. Mm. 5-1, just play up, check it down. Oh, why? there. I don't know. He played in and stepped one up with the back. Steenfant in 4-5 makes. And now he has a lot of gammon. 7-4 and 7. 12 crossovers before he's safe. Steen. 30%, 35% gammon, so what?
43.
43, okay, wow, that's a lot. Yeah.
6-3. I should have moved on to the 5 point there.
Okay.
Small arrow.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, because he cannot play them optimal anyways.
No.
So he has to waste some pips. Either way. Double fours?
4-2.
4-2, okay. Yeah.
Now he does the waste.
Yeah.
Anyways, so.
Yeah.
Oh, big
and
double three.
Yeah. This looks like 2 points. Were we too fast with the announcement of the commentator? Maybe?
Not sure if he was just going to ask Kette to come and join
okay,
us. But
yeah.
Let's see also if Kette just lost. He's probably not up to it. So.
No. It's okay.
Yeah.
We'll see. He might join us later.
So what's the issue here? He has to bring in 2 guys. Come on. Ah, of course you can play that one.
Okay, I have a request from a player that we explain some more concepts for the weaker players or the intermediates instead of the skilled players who knows the strategies anyways. So maybe explain the small split and so on when we say that. That's a good advice. We'll try to do that. They do play really fast, so let's see, but we'll try. It's a good
It is a 5-4, right?
Yeah, it looks like it.
Let's
see
how many points he takes. No, he saved it. 4-4.
Did he save it? Wow. Okay, we didn't even look. Oh, I didn't.
It wasn't doubled, so it wasn't doubled.
No. What's the? No,
yeah.
So he got
so
two?
So he got the gamble.
Okay,
okay.
I thought, what on earth?
So they're on break.
Yeah, we'll take a small break as well, and we'll be back shortly.
Yeah, let's just leave it here, so.
Har du lyst til en rigtig kaffe? Eller?
Ja, det kunne være dejligt. så mister man koncentrationen.
Ja.
Det er godt nok svært at
gøre det. Ja, hurtigt den XG der.
Ja.
Tag, når du spiller hurtigt.
Det var det.
So we are back and we know the players are about to seat, so it'll be a few minutes before the stream comes back up. It's delayed. So that was asked on the stream, who are we?
Well, I am Grandmaster Jess Danielsen from Denmark. I play on Steen Grønbæk's team, Casino Copenhagen. And Thomas?
Yeah, well, I am Thomas Fugler. I've just been playing for like 25 years, not in the top of the class, but getting there.
I've only played for 20.
Yeah. So basically, I'm just sitting here, standing or helping Jess, who is a well-known Danish player, theoretically strong, and aspiring for the Danish national team, I guess.
I'm close, but yeah. It's a tough lineup.
Yeah, it's a tough crew.
Yeah.
Yeah. So basically, I'm doing the XG and just trying to bring some comments to Jess's comments, asking some stupid questions, stuff like that.
And Thomas is one of the best streamers in Denmark.
Yeah.
One
doing
of them.
A lot of streaming, trying to keeping up. So basically, I'm here working at Nordic Open. I've been here for 3 days and started out like 9 or 10 this morning. So that's why we're getting a little bit tired also. So when they play fast, it's pretty difficult to follow up with the XG. I have a XG computer next to us, so that we're kind of leaning on the analysis of stream gammon. But it's very nice to hear Jess's comments and theories. We'll see if we can try to explain more for beginners
for
and intermediate as well.
Yes.
Right, so looks like they're sitting down, starting up 11-8 for Alain against Steen, your teammate.
Yes.
I kind of sensed that he was your teammate from the comments there. I feel a little, there's a little going on for Steen there.
I root for him, of course, but we both do probably, but
I'll see if I can root a little bit for Alain then, so that we even out.
I root for an interesting match, first of all.
Yeah, exactly. So basically also the dice, you can see that Steen is the only one throwing the dice in the battle box, and that's because they have agreed that Steen has the blue die and Alain has the red die.
Yeah, for the opening roll.
Yeah. It makes it a lot easier for those opening rolls that the dice does not hit each other and stuff like that.
Yeah.
It's been pretty common.
But it still confuses me because you cannot see who's on roll, but you have to look on the clock, but well, it's just a matter of getting used to it.
So that's
I normally don't play with the baffle box, I must admit.
6-4. Hit
double ones.
One.
Nice roll.
I'm up to speed here.
That's good. He steps up.
And there's a question from one here who, if we have any advice for casual player, how to get better? What should they do?
I would say get a hold of a good beginner's book. It could be Mark Olsen's From Basics to Badass. It could be Paul McGrill's Backgammon, The Bible.
That's the Bible, yeah.
Yeah. One of those two, I would say, if you read that and understand most of it, then you are well on your way. Then play as much as you can. Also live, I would say. Meet other players live and discuss positions. Then you should, within 20 some years, become a good player.
Well, as a big advantage for players starting up now, because the computer program Extreme Gammon in general neural bots have really revolutionized the way people play. I see a lot of players playing a lot better than in the old days, where we did not have computers to lean on, where we'd actually have to roll out positions manually. So this is a big thing. There's the internet where you can play, where you can play a lot of matches.
Yeah, but I would say that step two is buying Extreme Gammon in some form.
Yeah.
And practicing and looking up positions and so on. But get your basics right first, and then you sort of understand why some of the positions anyways.
Yeah.
Why the computer chooses those. So XG on your mobile or on PC is really valuable.
So Steen was just thinking here shortly about the cube.
Yeah, he's up a lot in the race probably.
And it was a small double take.
Okay,
how
yeah.
did he move that for one?
For one, he made the anchor. Or made the point, so and
yeah,
65.
Yeah, yes, of course.
Yeah. Do we have other?
Yeah, there's a few more questions here, so let's just take those.
There's someone says, never heard of her.
Yeah, that's us.
That's me, Jess. It's a male name
that
in
was,
Denmark, I must say.
That was why I was asking.
Okay,
before.
You have. Okay, you have actually.
That one, so that's the
thank you.
Green name here.
Good. Do. Yeah,
see
thank
if I
you.
Can catch up here.
I have. Okay, the one that asks about advice for casual players says, I've been playing XG for years, but I don't always understand why it
yeah.
wants me to do the things. And that is the concepts that you need to learn to understand the basics. Okay, this is a strong cube, and he passes right away.
And it is a big pass.
Yeah, big pass. Okay, yeah, but that can take many years to fully understand why the computer wants one move instead of another.
Yeah.
And
some of these concepts you can get from the books.
Yeah, yeah, you can.
And some of them, as you say, yes, you will get from playing a lot with other players and seeing them play.
Yeah.
And sometimes you could actually note if there's a position that you are totally, completely does not understand or agree with or whatever, you can actually line it up, set it up, and just play from that position several times and see
yeah.
what happens in this position from this position.
That's another good way of doing it.
And that's a very manual way, but it will make you somehow see in the end why you in the long run should make that move, of course.
Yeah, I agree. And also discuss positions with better players, maybe on forums on the internet, but it could also be in a live setting. Have a picture of a position that you don't understand and have a better player go through the position. That could give you some valuable knowledge also. So there are many ways of getting better, but it doesn't come cheap. You have to invest some time.
Yeah, and Steen is missing cubes now. He's already
oh, wow.
good enough
okay.
because he's trailing the match and he has 9 points, which makes him, he lacks an even points of numbers, which makes the doubles even better.
Now it's a big, big double, right?
Wait.
Yeah, okay, here it comes.
Yeah.
And can he even take this? It's a blitzy position. He has 10 checkers in the zone. The zone are the bottom of Steen's board. So he has 10 checkers for this attack. And he has escaped his backman also. Babylon has a blot in his own board. Steen has a lot of threats here. Fives cover directly. Twos, fours, and sixes hit. And he passes.
It's a huge pass, 530
yeah.
passes.
Okay,
so
big
pass.
One. Yeah, good.
So also when you mentioned that you should find somebody to play to, we must also admit that we live in Denmark. It's kind of the smallest
yeah.
country in the world, so
yeah.
we don't have big distances.
No.
And we have a lot of players to play with in the near area.
We probably have the biggest backgammon scene in the world.
Yeah.
So that's a big advantage for us. Several times a week we can go out and play live tournaments.
And a lot of small tournaments during weekends as well, so there's
yeah.
a lot to attend to to here.
And that spawns a lot of great players because
does.
There are so many players thinking about the game, playing the game, loving the game.
I know
so.
Michi, what is he, top three in the world?
Yeah, top two, I think.
Yeah.
yeah probably.
He was here. A few days before Nordic Open, he has a lot of friends here as well, And he went to visit Absalon, the new Danish club in Vesterbro, who has, I think it's like 100...
More than 100 players,
yeah.
Active players, I think, they are registered.
And so they have like this weekly tournament that they go play for free. And Michi was amazed on how this community was going on. So so that's kind of partly why we can do as we can in Denmark.
Okay, so we have a troll in the chat. He says, I hear a couple of online sites that can improve your skills, and his nick is Backgammon Studio. That is Terry from Norway. He has done an amazing job of building an online community and a place to play, and I can 100% recommend that site. Shout out to you, Terje. That is, of course, one of the other ways to get better. I use it myself many times a week. I play on Backgammon Studio. So, yeah, of course, play online as well. Really valuable. Yeah, okay, that's that. And you have to play, you have to think, and yeah that's how you get
time.
Better. It does take time. Yeah,
all
it's
right,
great
let's
that
get back here now.
Yeah.
Steen again has a double that he don't see.
Okay, wow, yeah, he has a huge race lead still.
Yeah, and he's by 16.
And now he probably lost his market. Now he has threats for the 1 point also. Or what? No, you I don't know. Is this a take? Double blood
still
in his board? I would not play the double blood anyways.
Still
but
a hole on that 5 point, but let's see, it's a good cube.
Yeah, it's a for sure it's a double, but can you even take this? Within a few rows...
28 pips down
no,
now.
No. I don't like it.
And
yeah.
It is a pass indeed.
Okay.
It's 188 pass. So
big pass.
Yeah.
Okay, good. But he did miss a few cubes or what?
Yeah, they were small actually.
Okay, really small
XG
ones.
XG changed
yeah.
it mine. It's mine, so...
Okay.
But there was just one cube before.
Okay.
Six error.
Okay,
so yeah,
it was
borderline.
Forgetting.
Yeah, very
yeah.
borderline. All right, can we see what happened here? Six
interesting
four?
That Steen made
two.
The 2 point in an equal score. It's now six away, and he does make the 2 point, but he must have his reasons because there are other alternatives.
And then 5-1, and what's this?
Yeah, 4-1, making
thanks.
The 7.
Yeah, thanks.
And 6-1.
Thank you.
Yeah. He probably, if you ask him, why did you make the 2 point in a six away, he can probably talk for 10 minutes about it, so it's not because he doesn't know what else to do. I can assure you of that. But it's still interesting. And split. You generally want to split your backmen early so you do not get primed. As well, this was a big role for Babylon. He escaped his back checker and made the point out there. The 15 point.
Liked the tempo hit on the 1 point there after the split. So
for
from Steen.
Okay. I didn't even see that. Yeah. Oh, instead of bringing down. Yeah, good. Now they are in some sort of a holding game again. Okay, he has to play it kind of. Awkward, but no alternative. Steen has a 6-4. Two down leaves the outfield.
He'll be up
to Babylon.
Seven pips after.
Yeah. Okay, he's a bit up in the race, but does he really want to leave all that outfield control? If he plays two down, I think, from the 13, he probably has to because he cannot place his checkers efficiently if he doesn't. Yeah.
Actually, doesn't like it.
It doesn't like
no,
it.
No, it wants to play inside
slot?
His homeland.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wow, interesting. Because it gets so easy for Babylon to clear his 15 point, which could be a real trouble for him later. And he probably has to do it now. He will only leave a 6-5 if he plays to the 7 point. I think that's the way to go. It's only two numbers that hit. So 15-7, I would say. What does XG say?
Let's see here. It wants to make 10 point now.
Oh, the 10 point. Yeah, okay. Okay. Yeah. So the leaving 11. Oh, yeah, he sees it actually. Yeah. Priming. Only 5-4 and 5-6 hits. That's good. 5 what?
3,
five,
I guess.
3. Okay, that was a good play by Babylon. Yes. Bredel sees the 10 point. That's good.
Yeah.
I was a bit sleepy there. But what does Steen do here? Babylon has the far weaker board with blots and all. Can he step out?
It's this totally even race before the roll, so
okay.
Before the move.
So he will be up 8?
Yeah.
Can you step out? Create some contact? So do you do that?
No,
out and
I
in?
I don't like it because he will have... it's not so many... It's only 5s getting that last checker out, so that could be a problem.
But there will be some... numbers that doesn't clear all the blots for Babylon.
Yeah, exactly. But,
so
but still, it's trapped that last checker, so you cannot just move out and then expect to be in a race.
I would not run all the way. I would play in.
Ah.
This one.
Okay.
Because there are many shot numbers here for Babylon.
But you still leave that back checker behind and still
I like it.
That
I do like it.
Probably right.
This is an advanced play.
Definitely an advanced play.
Yeah.
And it is correct.
Oh, wow. Cool.
And still, yeah, the second best is still going out, so you definitely need to go out. Did you see what was the blue
3
guys?
Something.
Yeah, okay.
Probably not double 3s. That's a guess.
Yeah.
But this will probably be a blood-giving number of some sort. He might be forced to hit and cover or something, or leave
something
a 6
like
shot or
3,
something.
3-4 maybe.
Could be 3-4, but that's the upside, the big upside of this play that Steen made. A lot of numbers leave a shot here, and Steen has a winning board.
6-3 says Carsten.
6-3
is also leaving blots.
Yeah, it is a 6-3. We can see it when the shadow comes over there, and he has to hit and cover. And now Steen has to double. I would say this is a hugely volatile position. He hits with deuces. And he enters and hits with 5s, 1-5, 4-5, 5-5. I think, can you double here? I think you can.
You just said it, you just said it. Yeah.
I would probably.
Good, and he's looking at it, so just let me know when you want the hint here.
Yeah, I go for the double here because it is so volatile. Of course, it's not fun when you fan or when you come in with a
5-3,
for
three,
example.
5-3
is a bad number.
Five,
but still,
six.
If you hit, you miss or you lose your market instantly, probably. I don't know. It's a big, big no double.
Yeah.
There we go.
But very interesting. Very interesting
to
look at this one.
Because he's primed. He's too primed, I guess, for the double. Sometimes it can be hugely correct to double these. Because they are so volatile.
And that's also why Steen is looking at now.
Yeah, yeah. There are deuces, double one, 1-5, 4-5, 5-5. It's 15 numbers that hit. Yeah, he waits. Okay, it's good.
And he's down in the race as well. So if he kind of anchors, he's in trouble still.
Yeah,
so 5-1 and 4s
that's right.
Are not that good.
No.
They're just kind of life-saving.
4-6, for example.
Yeah.
5-6. Is even worse.
Yeah.
So,
so maybe if he was up 10 pips in the race, it would be a strong double.
Yeah. He has 15 fantastic numbers, but he also has a lot of bad numbers. So yeah, it's a costly double. I eat my words. He does it.
But
okay.
He does it.
Yeah. He's.
And Babylon recognizes this.
Yeah, 2-5 double hits. That is a huge one. It's this can be the match.
Now he gets rewarded.
Yeah.
They used to get punished in the match earlier,
yeah.
So but now they get rewarded.
this can win him the match, actually, this this double. So that was interesting. He's and
I am transcribing.
Yeah.
Come in, snack.
Okay,
and
so
then you have to say something clever about that double one. So we just have Casper in the room, my colleague.
Here, Steen can play pretty free because he has two men on the bar.
Okay, du tager XG.
So he can.
Du skal bare trykke start stream og start recording.
So he can flex it. Oh no, I don't like this one. But he can flex it a lot because Babylon has two checkers on the bar. Of course, you don't want to be. Oh wow, is this? Can this be correct? I do not like that. But oh well.
So he did as well.
I've never seen that being correct.
It is an error, but
it's a blunder.
It comes to a blunder now.
Yeah, it becomes a blunder. I don't know what he thought about there, but you generally don't want to make the ace point if you don't have to. He wasn't forced to do it. Okay, here he can. He has a chance to anchor. He doesn't. Okay, good. And he.
That's an awkward one.
Yeah, it is. It doesn't hit anything at all. Wow, two, threes, fours, and fives hit, and he doesn't roll it. You probably just go all the way. Yeah, this is good. Twos and threes want to escape, and he also hits with twos and threes, so he could play the ace to four, but then he doesn't get the fourth builder for the three point.
Could he stay and bury that 8 point checker?
I wouldn't do that.
No,
he needs it for the attack. 4-3, oh wow.
Now he's back.
Babylon is instantly back from a position where he lost so many gammons. He is...
Ooh, close. But he needs to save those guys. So.
Yeah. He has trouble on both sides of his board.
He's thinking of duplicating some fives here, I guess.
Mm.
But that's not... He just needs to save. No, it's correct. He should have duplicated.
Okay, so step up.
Yeah.
Step okay.
Up.
Yeah, that's difficult to find.
Now he will just find himself buried.
So this is
the hole even deeper.
This is six away. So Babylon can also be aggressive with the free cube. So he shouldn't wait too long. This can be the match. Should
probably just make the natural one. Yeah, the 5 point here.
5 point. Yeah.
Is he nuts? That's a 270 error to make
big,
the 4 point.
Big error to make the 4 point. You want to
what
make
the... What did Steen make there? It does 2-1, I guess.
Yeah.
6-5.
6-5,
two
out. Ensuring a double shot if he should jump the prime. Steen doesn't.
And how about the cube now?
Yeah,
then?
I'm contemplating the cube now. He has 5-5, 5-1.
He's down 43.
Yeah, it's difficult. It's really difficult. Maybe he needs a bit more checkers to make.
Yeah.
If you have three checkers to make the 5 point, then it's a huge double.
Yeah. I think it comes down to the threats. Yeah.
Yeah. So he doesn't have that many immediate threats.
It is a redouble.
It's
XG likes it.
70.
70 error not to redouble.
Yeah. And the window is fairly small.
Well, same. 70-70. 70 take and a 70 redouble.
But now if he improves, then it becomes an even bigger redouble. So the mistake becomes gradually bigger.
Yeah. And I think maybe that 5 from Steen also makes him realize that Steen is actually about to crunch his board and worsen his position, which makes Alan's position even stronger.
Yes, exactly.
So now it may be a little bit more obvious to him that he can actually double.
Entries like 2-4 and so on, if Steen was hit, would break his board. So
and even not hit and just rolling,
this
and
is big now
breaking. Yeah, it is.
This and double fours,
does he get punished somehow? It's not you probably make
he can make the point
four,
the 2 point in his head. He probably has to
and then bring down the extra
bill. No, he could just play this checker
safe
up all the way and from 6 to to 2.
I would start
one,
to make the
2 point
3-4 and think about bringing down the extra
true
build.
Yeah, that's the right way to do it. Do it in order.
Yeah.
But I think this is how you do it, because you block the double fives, which is Steen's getaway number. So this must be correct to make the 2 point.
Yeah.
He is not happy when Steen rolls 5-6 or 5-4, but that's how it goes.
Yeah.
He does fan on 16 numbers.
So XG also likes, but it's a 22 error to bring down those extra builders.
Okay, to leave the three numbers. But still, you lose the game on 5-5. You actually go some gammons.
Yeah.
Also. This is well played. And Steen rolls a 5, that's good for him.
Staying alive.
And what about now?
What about
if
now?
He... Yeah, that's a good cube.
There's still a big cube.
Good cube.
And now it's a big take.
It's still a big take?
Yeah.
Wow. Wow, wow, wow.
Before, it was just a very, very tiny borderline take before the 4-4.
No, it's not. It's a, oh, sorry.
Yeah,
sorry.
So this one.
Okay, yeah.
And then this, of course. Was
Steen takes.
Steen
great.
Takes, yeah.
Well played. Both, actually, but Babylon missed a few. See, if Steen doesn't return this with the 5, then he's done. But now he can actually win. So that's the a bad one. You could say, but this can be the
now?
Match. This can be the match now.
Is that just recoup for the match, or should he? Be, and he has freak gammons.
He only gains 2 points if he rolls on.
Yeah.
So 6 away, 2 away. Is what Babylon is looking at if he passes. There are quite a few gammons in this. But he only gains 2 points from it, so
would
maybe...
Would Steen be scared maybe that he would get hit back on that 3 point and, yeah, you know...
Plus
spoiling.
He could roll a...
Could he try to cash instead of
6-3 or something? If he rolls 6-3, he leaves the shot that could lose him the...
Yeah, exactly.
Maybe you want to go
for
the catch.
Or 5-4 or something.
Yeah, but
like
it hits. So he...
It hits, but if he gets hit back,
he
can come in on
the... But 6-3 was the worst that I could find.
Definitely.
Because it doesn't hit and it leaves the checker down there. This is difficult. Yeah, this is really difficult.
And also, what does he expect white to do?
Yeah, I think Babylon must pass this, but... 6 away, 2 away.
So what does that make his take point here?
Yeah, that's what I'm looking at right here.
So Mr. Theory Bredal says big pass.
Yeah, 19% take point here.
Yeah.
So if white has anything less than 19%, he has to pass. If he has more, and he doesn't even have to look at the gammons. If he has more than 19% in this position, he has to take. But I cannot find 19% in this one. I really can't.
It depends if the glass is half full or half empty.
Yeah, yeah, but he will pass this, I'm sure.
Yeah, let's see.
No, he takes it right
and
away.
And it is a take, it is.
Whoa. Okay.
It's 150 takes.
It's
so
a huge
this
take.
This is it.
Wow.
This is it, we're on for the match.
It was a borderline double, and... It was a big take.
Yeah.
He actually white has 24.7% in this position. Okay.
And he should probably just lift the one here. There's
here you lift. He doesn't play on for the gammons.
Steen, take care. It's a 17 error.
Okay.
But still.
It's a small error, but conceptually, why would he leave that blot? Of course. Of course, this leaves 3-3, 3-6, 3-1. So that's 5 shots instead of the 11.
Yeah. But you would have 2 on the bar. But
it's
some awkward entries.
It's difficult. Have. It's a difficult decision.
It is. I cannot see why it's so close on the XG, but it is. It is 17.
No, it's really close because the upside is you get 2 on the bar.
Yeah.
But
still, if Steen... gets hit back and he enters, that's
5
a lot
numbers,
of re-entering that actually would break his board.
Oh,
and
he fans.
So now he's in very good shape. Steen.
Yeah, I must say.
Was that
5-2?
Five,
that?
Two,
I think so.
He
I
doesn't hit
so.
Right away.
Yeah.
So
2-5,
yeah.
That's not a good number. He would rather have hit another guy here, so there were no bad numbers.
Magic coming over.
No,
3-6. Could have been good for
4-1. Plays all the way, so he's not uneven, or what do you call it?
Yeah.
So he doesn't have an uneven number on his two last points. Oh, and this is why double five would have left a shot if he had taken the checker off here. So this is, and it's over.
And that's
it's over.
That's it.
Shake hands. Yep, there it was. Wow, what a game this last one. Fantastic. Okay.
Yeah, let's just see the comments here. That went quite fast from yeah. What can you say? Steam was trailing, and then all of a sudden he was back in. Whoa.
Yeah, my colleague, partner in crime, Carsten Bredal, says take point is 19 and White does not have that much. And then he was surprised at the 24 as well as I was. And gammons doesn't count, that's right.
Yeah, so basically he has 29% in the take position. So so that's...
That was exciting,
yeah.
And difficult, not to say the least. But no, thanks for looking.
I'm at the wrong cube here. He has 24.7%.
Yeah, and he needed 19%, so yeah. Thank you for joining us. That was fun.
Thanks for viewing.
Thanks.
Thanks, Jess,
Thomas.
For commenting. Very
You're
nice
welcome.
That you came by to
You're
some
welcome.
Comments. It's really difficult to find some of the expert players to come and comment because they're all playing in different events. There was the mix double event starting tonight at 9:30. We're really hoping tomorrow that we could get some players to comment during the day. And yes, of course, you are most welcome to stop by. It's
I
very nice.
I might stop by tomorrow night.
Yeah,
maybe.
That'd be cool.
Okay.
Please write to me and let's make it happen.
Thank
it's
you.
Really nice.
It was fun.
Thank you.
Thanks.